Welcome to the practical session. Our first function is strlen, and strlen is used for finding a string length, and these all are the functions which we are using in this practical. These all functions available in our one library, that is string.h. So in definition you can see on the screen that demonstrate the use of inbuilt function for string, and the functions are strlen, then after strcpy, strncpy, then next is a strcat, same way strncat, strcmp, strncmp, and last is a strrev. So let's start with very first function, that is strlen, and for using this function include the library hash include string.h. Our first function is strlen, that is used for finding a string length. How? Suppose I am enter my name as a string like genal, so our output is like 5, because in genal total 5 characters are present, first J, I, N, A, L. So declare first the string, and the data type is used for string is character, and S 10. 10 is the size of our string. Then after, how we can find the length? First of all, we can directly here assign the value of our string, but I am using getS function, means input the string from the user, and for string we can use getS function as our input function. We can also use scanf function, but the limitation of scanf function is when space is present in our string terminated from the space. That's why always we have to use getS function as our input function for string. So first I am writing printf enter string, then write the getS function, and the syntax of getS is like in getS in bracket write the array name, that is S. Now we have to use strlen function. So first I am taking one integer variable. Why integer? Because our length answer we will get in integer form. That's why I am declaring one variable integer L as our length, and after input I am writing L is equal to our function strlen, and in bracket we have to pass S because we want to find the string length of our variable S, means the value which is stored in our variable S. Last, print the value of L variable because our answer is stored in L. So printf string length is equal to percentage d. Why percentage d? Because L variable is in integer form, that's why. So here in this way we can find the string length. Let's compile the program. You can see errors warning 00. So run the program. Here first enter string. So I am enter string as genal. So you can see the output 5. Again run the program. I am enter one another string, that is abc xyz. So here you can see the answer 7. Space is also considered as a character. So first 3 abc, then xyz, 3 plus 3 6, and 1 is for space. So our output is string length is equal to 7. So first function is completed. Now move to the second one, that is strcpy. And what is the use of strcpy? Strcpy is used for copy one string to another. So here we have to require one another character array. So I am declaring one array that is t and 10. I am removing previous function. And how we can use strcpy function? So remember the syntax of strcpy. Strcpy in bracket source array and destination array. So I am writing strcpy in bracket. I want to copy the data of s into our t character array, means t string. So I am writing t comma s. So how it will execute? First of all, enter the string. Suppose I am enter abc in our s variable. So the same thing copy into our new variable, new string, that is t, and finally print the value of t variable. So here string t is equal to percentage s. Why percentage s? Because for printing string our control string is percentage s, and comma, our variable name is t. So let's compile the program and run the program. Enter the string. Suppose I am enter abc. So here you can see in output string t is equal to also abc, because the data of s is copied here in our t string. That's why we can also use strcpy function directly here. Suppose I want to copy xyz in our t string, so it is also possible. Run the program. So I am entered the value of abc of s string, but here you can see the output t is equal to xyz. Why? Because we copy xyz in our t variable. Now next function is strncpy. It is similar to strcpy, function is same, only difference is it will copy only n character. So how we can use it? Here you have to write strn, and here after two strings we have to enter one constant value. So I am entering 1. Now how we will get the output? Suppose I am enter abc in s string, but here only one character of the s string will be copy in our second string, that is t. So let's see output. First compile the program and run the program. So here I am entering abc, but here you can see the output. In t only first character of s is stored, and t is equal to a is our output. Suppose I am writing 2 instead of 1. Now what will be the output? First two character of s string will be copy in our second variable, that is t. So compile and run. Here our input is abc, and in t our output is only ab, because our n value is 2. So only first two character will be copy in our second variable. So in this way we can use strcpy as well as strncpy for copy. Our next function is strcat. What is the use of strcat? Strcat means string concatenation. If we want to merge two different string together in one string, then it is possible with strcat function. So let's see how we can use it. First of all, here we have to enter both the string, because we have to merge one string with another string. So input another string, I'm copy this and paste. Here I am writing enter string 1, and here I am writing enter string 2, and in get is first variable is s and second variable is t. So our input part is completed. Now use the strcat function. So just change here strcat and t comma s. Now how we will get the output? Suppose in s I am enter abc and in t I am enter xyz. So here I am using t comma s, means in t variable our data of s will be copy after value of t. So let's see the output. First compile and run. So enter string 1, I am enter abc, and enter string 2, I am enter xyz. So here string t is equal to xyz abc, because our first string is merged here with our second string. So our second string is as it is xyz, and then after abc is merging here. But suppose I am changed the value here, that instead of t comma s I am writing s comma t, then what will be the output? Suppose I am enter string 1 as abc and second as xyz and print the value of s, in this case we will get output abc xyz. How? Let's see. Compile and run. So enter abc xyz. So our output is like abc xyz. So in this way strcat is working. Now similar function is strncat. So strncat merge or concat only n characters. So suppose I am enter here 2, and let's see the output. Suppose I am enter abc and second string is xyz. Now what will be the output? So only first two characters of string 2 will be merged after the string 1. So our output is like abc xy only. Z will be discarded because only first two character will be merged here. Suppose I am writing 1 instead of 2, then only first character will be merged. How? Let's see. Enter string 1, that is abc, second is xyz. So you can see the output only abc x, only first character is merged after the first string. So in this way we can use strncat for merging n characters. Now next function is strcmp. What is the use of strcmp? It is used for string comparison. So input part already I have right here, but if you want to use strcmp function, then we have to write this function in if. Why? Because when we use this function, our function value becomes 0, then we can say that both strings are equal, otherwise our strings are not equal. Why? Because it is work on the ASCII values difference. So how we can write? Just write the condition if, then in if write the function, that is strcmp, and in bracket write the variable s comma t, and if this function value difference we will get 0, in this case we can say that our both strings are equal. So I am writing both strings are equal, and also we have to write false part, that is else, and in else write printf both strings are not equal. So run the program. enter string 1. Suppose I am enter ABC as our first string and XYZ as our second string. So ABC and XYZ both are different string, right? So our output is both strings are not equal. But if I am enter both string ABC ABC, then our output is like both strings are equal. How? So let's see. Suppose I am enter ABC, again ABC. So you can see the output, both strings are equal. So in this way we can compare the strings using strcmp, and the similar function is strncmp, that is compare n characters. So suppose I am enter here 1, after comma I am writing 1. So it will check only first character of both the string, and a first character of both the string will be matched, then it will print the output that both strings are equal. So compile the program and run the program. So enter string 1, I am enter ABC, and here I am enter ADC. So here you can see that our first character of both the string are equal. So our output is like both strings are equal. But if I am enter first string as ABC, ABS, and second is DFG, then here A and D not match, that's why our else part will be execute and our output is like both strings are not equal. So in this way we can use strncmp for comparing n character. Suppose I am taking here 2 instead of 1, then it will check first 2 characters. Let's see. Suppose I am enter hi, and again second string is HIE. So here you can see that our first 2 characters same. So our output is both strings are equal. But here I am enter ABC and here ADC. So first characters are same, but second character not match. In that case our output is both strings are not equal. And our last function is strrev. Strrev is used for string reverse. So just remove this all part. And how we can write strrev? So write strrev and in bracket our string name. So here our string is s. So our string is reverse now, and after reversing the string for output we have to print the same string. And for printing we can use putS function. putS is similar to the printf function. So putS s, and here one printf reverse string. So compile the program and run the program. Enter string 1. I am entering A, B, C. So here you can see the reverse string, that is C, B, A. Again run the program for second input. Suppose I am entering hello. So you can see the reverse of hello, that is O double L E H. So in this way we can find the reverse using inbuilt function, that is strrev. And we have also many more functions that we can convert the string in uppercase, lowercase, find the substring or find the sub character using inbuilt function. Hope guys you understand this lecture practical session very well, and these all inbuilt function are very easy and it is very important topic for exam. Thank you for listening.